A new must-watch theater play features two of the world's most acclaimed Filipino stage actresses, Golden Globe nominee Dolly De Leon and Tony Award winner Lea Salonga, will be alternating for the main role in Request Sarajo, a landmark theatrical piece that captures the solitude of a woman. And what an honor to have with us here live on the studio again. Is this your third time?
I think it's my second.
Second live. Request Sarajo. We're joined by the one and only Dolly De Leon. Can everybody
Hi.
Here give it a give this a hand? Oh my God, Dolly.
Dolly, it's
welcome
so nice to be back.
My gosh, I'm so honored you are back on Kedstar.
I'm honored to be here. Okay. I love being here.
Thank you.
Kahit ang aga-aga.
Okay, number one, why do Request Sarajo? You're in Hollywood films. You're doing international TV series on Amazon. One would think, makukuha pa ba natin si Dolly De Leon? She's so busy. She's now doing, you know, a broadcast work. Why go back to theater?
Ay, pagdating talaga sa place, that's my first love eh. So, no-brainer yan. When it was offered to me by Clint Ramos, I was like, a play, yes. My last play was 5 years ago. And theater is really my true love, my first and true love. So, of course, I said yes. And secondly, because of the subject matter, it's about mental health.
Yeah.
And I'm a strong advocate of mental health. I really believe that we need to, you know, open the doors for them, for the topic, for it to be talked about. Because it's been taboo for such a long time. But today, it's time to avoid the problem and face it head on.
Okay. Request Sarajo isn't a regular play. Okay?
No, it's not. It's
now,
not.
Give us an idea of what we will see.
You will see the routine of a woman who lives alone and
okay.
who lives a very lonely life without a mask, without pretense, just her being herself because she's alone, no one's watching her.
Uh-oh. But so, then, is it true? Okay, I want to ask you this. Is there dialogue in the play?
Wala. There's no dialogue.
Oh my, okay. Now, there are people watching you now. Why will they watch Dolly De Leon and Lea Salonga not speaking at all?
Well, they're gonna watch Lea Salonga for not speaking at all because she's known to use her
to
voice
sing.
When she performs. So, I mean, every fan of Lea Salonga would love to see that. And I've talked to people already and they're excited about that aspect. For me, di ko alam, bakit nga ba?
No, why will they watch? Why will they watch you both that you're not speaking for an hour?
Because it sounds cliche, but actions speak louder than words. It's through our actions, it's through what we're doing on stage where you're going to see what we're really feeling inside without us saying anything. And I think that's the beauty of Request Sarajo.
Oh, now, Request Sarajo, let's talk about this first. Is this an original?
It's a German play.
Okay.
But by Franz Xaver Kreitz.
Uh-oh.
Written in the 70s.
Mm-hmm. And it was a hit then.
Yes. And it's been restaged in three different languages already.
Mm-mm.
So this is like, I think, the fourth adaptation. It's adapted to Filipino.
Okay.
So even if there are no words, there's still a lot of Filipino influence in the material.
Okay.
Because the character that we play is Filipina.
So here they are. They're watching you on stage. This is going to be at the Samsung Theater.
Yes.
Right. So I've been there. It's quite huge.
Yes.
So how will they see Dolly De Leon's facial expressions if they're asking, if we're seated in the back, for example?
It's a very intimate set.
It is.
Very, very intimate. Ang capacity kasi ng Samsung is 1,500. But
yeah.
For this one, it's only 400.
Yeah.
So the last row will probably be like 20 feet away. Very, very close. And the first row will be super close, almost intrusive. And it's very intimate. It's gonna be a big, big, big room where mm-hmm. everyone is inside that big room, mm-hmm. including the audience.
Okay, what do you like about this character? I mean, other than the fact that Clint asked you, it's a famous play, Lea Salonga is, in a way, you're working with her on
yes.
this. Why would you do this?
I love Miss Reyes because she represents every Filipino who has left home to find greener pastures in other countries.
Okay.
They've made sacrifices. She has made a sacrifice to leave her family, let go of the comforts of home, and go outside, which is alien to her. She's not familiar with the language, with the culture, with everything. She lives alone. And for me, that's a very it's a very important story to tell because mm-hmm. a lot of our kababayans are living that life.
Uh-oh. So is it right to say Mrs. Reyes, who is an OFW?
Miss Reyes.
Miss Reyes yeah. is an OFW.
Yes, she
in the
is.
Filipino version.
Yes, she's a she's an OFW, overseas foreign worker. And she's based in, we've established it as New York. She lives in New York. She's been there for a while, for a long time. And she lives alone, and she basically has no family with her there.
Okay. Now, are there other characters in this play, or literally it is Dolly De Leon on stage alone?
Yes, there are other characters.
There are.
The props.
Seriously?
The props and the set are characters all on their own, swear. Yeah. It's a totally different experience. Yeah.
Now, we've seen this. There are Broadway plays and off-Broadway plays where it's a solo, right? What do you call those?
A one-hander.
There's a one-hander. One-hander.
Yeah.
But then there's usually a monologue of some sort.
Yes.
So how different is this to actually rehearse, practice, that it's all your facial expressions, it's all your body movements, and it's just you?
It's really hard. It's muscle memory, eh? Because memorizing lines, you understand why you're saying things. But here, it's all muscle memory, and there's really more or less no logic to why she does things at a certain order. Because even if we come home and we have a routine, sometimes we mix them up. But for her, it has to be done in a chronological order. So it's a challenge. Medyo mahirap siya na tandaan yung mga actions.
Okay, will the audience cry? Will they be upset? What kind of emotions are we going to see here?
The hope is that they appreciate people like her who are going through a mental crisis, or that they will be able to empathize with people who live abroad, especially people who have relatives abroad, and be more empathetic to the struggle that they have there. If they cry, then that's a good thing. If they're happy when they watch it, it's also a good thing. Whatever emotion they feel when they watch it is valid. As long as they understand the perspective of a person who is going through extreme loneliness and depression.
Okay. Now, who funded Request Sarajo? I mean, is this a Clint Ramos project completely? He was here. He was here on Head Start, by the way. Yeah.
Yeah. He's our producer. He also adapted the play. He's also our set designer.
Wow.
Grabe si Clint.
Yeah.
It's in partnership with Samsung Performing Arts Theater, Philippine Airlines, and BPI.
Okay.
So, but it's really mostly Clint who's the brains of everything. Uh-oh. And of course, our director, Bobby Garcia.
Yeah. Bobby is still at it. Huh?
Yes, he is. He never stopped. He's been directing in Canada. So it's for his first time again to direct here in the Philippines.
Okay.
And my first time to work with him.
All right. Now, you've also never stopped. Segue. Okay, from the time I interviewed you here, Triangle of Sadness, that was like the breakthrough film, right? It changed the game for you. What have you been doing after Triangle of Sadness?
After Triangle, I've been working here. I've been working abroad. So abroad...
Of course, there's a good girl.
A very good girl.
A very good girl. That was
cinema.
A hit. Okay, go
I
on.
Did that. I did two Cinemalaya films.
Yeah.
I did a film with Reality Entertainment.
Wow,
also, Keys
busy.
To the Heart.
Okay.
And then I did three films in the States. Ghostlight, Between the Temples, and Jackpot.
Okay, I want to hear about that. I know there was one time I spoke with you. You were playing either a Jewish stepmother?
Yes.
Okay.
In Between the Temples.
All right. Has it been, is it showing?
It's showing in the States now. It's in cinemas in the States. And Ghostlight is streaming.
Is that? I want to watch
it's
that.
It's not streaming here in the Philippines.
It's not?
No, it's not.
Okay. All right. Now, you were also in Munich. Let's talk about that a bit.
Yeah.
It is that show now. So, you were doing a series, the second season of...
9 Perfect Strangers, starring Nicole Kidman. I play one of the 9 strangers because the strangers change per season. So, in season 1, that was a different set of actors. Now, it's a different set of actors. I was there for 6 months. That's why gets na gets ko si Miss Reyes of living alone in an apartment by yourself, working for your family.
Okay. Do you experience, I'm just curious, I mean, you're now exposed internationally, globally. Is it difficult to be cast, given that, how do they call you? Do they just say, okay, she looks Filipina, or she can look Japanese, is it difficult, Dolly?
You know what's great about nowadays? They don't cast you anymore based on your ethnicity.
That's true.
Unless you're a family and your child has to kind of look like you and the father, then that's when it becomes a problem. But so far, like, I've I've been cast for parts that were originally cast for white people, but they considered me for it because the ethnicity doesn't matter in the storyline. So, like in Ghostlight and in Between the Temples and in other projects that I'm going to do in the future, may isa pa nga nakalagay requirement, standard American accent. So I told my agent, teka muna, I don't want to do that. I want to represent the Filipino. And she said, no, don't mind that. It's okay. And then when I spoke to the director, sinabi niya nga na, it doesn't matter. You can speak in your own accent.
And this is your own accent?
This is my own accent.
Okay, but can you do several accents like Meryl Streep?
Siguro, no. Oh my gosh, no. Hindi po, Chang Meryl.
But let's try.
But maybe with a speech.
Can you do a British accent? I think you can.
Maybe with a speech coach and a diction coach, I can do it.
You can.
Yeah, but iba tayo, iba yung dila natin Pinoy eh. We're not like the Americans na it's easy for them to do the British accent. For me, it's not. I'm sure si Lea kayang-kaya. Pero I need a teacher.
You need a teacher. But would you want to do something like...
I would be open to doing that if I had plenty of time to prepare and if I'm provided a diction coach. Yeah, why not?
Okay.
I'd be
now,
open.
Among all the international stars you worked with, who did you love the most?
That I worked with?
Worked with.
Annie Murphy and Murray Bartlett and Christine Baranski.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, she's hilarious.
Yeah, she's really a classy lady. And she's so funny. She's funny in real life. So, yeah. And Keith Kupfer, he's our lead in Ghostlight. And Jason Schwartzman, also our lead in Ghostlight.
Oh, I like that guy. He's funny too.
And he's a nice guy.
Have you ever experienced discrimination at any point?
You know, I haven't really experienced discrimination right on my face.
Yeah.
I've been lucky to work with really beautiful people on film sets. The crew, the staff, everybody has been really great. But there is an underlying racism kind of thing.
Uh-oh.
It's really more of them being overprotective of you and watching out for you and looking out for you that... You know, it's a nice gesture. It's sweet, but it makes me feel. It reminds me more
that
of
you're
my
different.
Ethnic. Yes,
oh, that's a very
that's,
good.
Yeah, that's the difference. I think it's because I'm an older actress, so siguro iba yung trato nila sa mas nakakatanda sa kanila, so they're nicer to me. Maybe if I were younger, it would be different. I don't know. Or maybe it's because the way the world is so woke now that they're being very careful. Pero to the point of too much na, yung parang treat me the same na lang.
Yeah.
Don't give me special treatment. Don't treat me special. Treat me the same as you treat everybody else.
What do you say? I have to say, from the time that you were on Head Start, from Triangle of Sadness, where, by the way, if you forgot, she auditioned via Zoom.
I did.
On that one.
Yeah.
With no agent, really.
No, for Triangle of Sadness. I auditioned face-to-face, and then I was interviewed by the director.
But there was a Zoom part.
Yeah,
online,
Skype. Panon, wala pang Zoom nun. Skype pa nun.
Wala pang Zoom nun?
Oh, hindi siya sikat. Hindi pa siya sikat. Sikat nun Skype.
Oh my gosh.
2018 yan
eh. So, okay. From that time, look at how your career has actually flown. It's been, is it right to say 2 years?
Yeah, 2 years. Exactly 2 years.
Just 2 years and your projects are non-stop.
Yeah.
What can you say? I mean, you're extremely blessed.
I'm blessed. I'm grateful that this is happening to me, but it's also a statement on how the industry treats actors like me. It's like, why do we have to wait for affirmation from other countries to believe in our own talent?
Yeah.
Why can't we recognize that we have a great bunch of actors and artists in our country? Ang dami-dami naming napaka-talented. So it's that mindset, I think, that needs to be changed. We don't need to wait for outside affirmation. We should recognize how talented our people, our actors really are. And, you know, I'm fortunate. I'm lucky that it happened. Well, lucky dahil ako yung napili ni Ruben Oslund. Pero at the same time, it's a bit disappointing lang na bakit kailangan maging ganun? Bakit kailangan, pag sinabi ng mga puti na maganda, ibig sabihin maganda talaga, bakit hindi tayo magkaroon ng sariling opinion?
Mm-hmm. Could it be, because I'm just asking, that the market in the Philippines is small? Because when you hit a global market and you've crossed over, that's why there's that, if in New York, if I can make it there, I'll make it
that's
anywhere.
That's true also.
It's like a melting pot.
That's also true. I mean, I've experienced exposure
yeah.
because it it was released internationally. Mm. That's true. Pero while I was in this country working here, no one recognized any of my talents, diba? Yeah. And I was coming, I was all over the place.
My favorite line when you were on Head Start, ito. Karen, yung mga script na nakukuha ko, niwala ng pangalan, neighbor. I will never forget, neighbor,
yes.
Teacher.
Woman one.
Woman one.
Oh,
woman one. Diba? Oh.
So, but, di ba, ba't kailangan ma-recognize ka sa ibang bansa bago ka ma-recognize dito? Yung, kasi masyado tayong, sorry, masyado tayong celebrity-centric dito sa country na to.
Eh. And lagi, abroad, but they're not. But they, I mean,
they really, they are too. Of course, they are. Kaya lang, I work here, so syempre, this is the world that I know.
But the difference abroad is this, at I think, in the Philippines, there seems to be an obsession in terms of celebrity with youth. Abroad,
yes.
You have Meryl Streep, who's, I mean, how old now?
Yes.
Right? I mean, at the end of the day, you see the track record. You love them for just acting.
Yes, and there kasi, I'm not saying they're better, ha?
Yeah.
It's not that they're better, eh. It's just that mas broad ang perspective nila. They tell stories about people
all
from
kinds.
All walks of life. All genders. Pero minsan may pay gap pa rin sa kanila hanggang ngayon. Hindi, wala naman perfect na sitwasyon. Pero at least nandun na sila na they tell stories about middle-aged women. They cast people who are not famous.
Yeah.
They don't cast people based on their celebrity status or their popularity or how many followers they have on Instagram.
Very good.
They
yeah.
cast based on appropriate casting. If you're perfect for the part, then ikaw yung cast.
Yeah.
Yun lang, sana mas ganun tayo mag-isip rather than always casting the same people all the time. Dahil sikat sila and they will pull an audience. Although I understand na kailangan natin yon because we need people to buy our tickets.
Yeah.
But there must be some other way that we can pull people in to watch.
Yeah, maybe, no, I love that you said that.
Diba? Maybe make more compelling stories that people can relate to, that people want to watch. And trust that your actors will deliver the story according to what's given on the material and so that people can relate to it.
Yeah, no, I mean like just like Lily Gladstone of the Killers of the Flower Moon,
exactly.
Like completely
unknown
from nowhere.
Siya.
Unknown.
Yeah.
With Leonardo DiCaprio.
And Scorsese pa.
Oh, yeah.
Diba? Para gawin niya yon, ang laking risk na ginawa niya, pero dahil nagtiwala siya sa artista, kinas niya, unknown, tinamo, nanalo ng Best Supporting Actress, diba?
Yes. Oh. Okay, but okay. Now, going back to you is this. Actually, you are a success story. You know, you Lea Salonga is one of them, and you are one of these Filipinos who carry the flag proudly abroad. Many people, when they see you, they say, "Nagawa ni Dali De Leon, so kaya ko rin, hindi hopeless, kaya ko rin ito." What else? What is your big dream?
My big dream is to produce something there.
I support you.
Thank you. So, partner tayo.
Okay, support something abroad. Go on.
Yes,
okay,
I want to work with a group of people who are focused on the PhilAm community and the PhilAm talents there and produce material catered to that demographic.
Yeah, because they're very big.
Yes, they are. Yes, and they're so underrated. They're so underrated and unrecognized. So I want to give them a platform. I want to be there and produce stuff for them. And not necessarily na ikakast rin ako. So yun ang big picture for me. I want to eventually produce.
Okay, let's declare that. It's gonna happen
let's
here.
Let's declare that.
Because Dolly De Leon said it on Head Start.
Yes.
Now, Request Sarajo. You have a preview on October 9, but when does it really... When does it start?
The run is on October 10 until the 20th. That's two shows every day. Lea has one show. I have one show.
Okay.
Every day.
Every day.
Except Monday. Except on a Monday in that period. Kasi Monday, sarado ang theater. That's the norm.
Did you feel any form of pressure at all that your alternate is Lea? I'm just curious from where you stand.
Honestly, no. Kasi it's a wordless play.
I love it. Yeah.
And for me kasi, it's not a competition.
Yeah.
I see this talaga sa partnership and I told her this. For me, for all of us, Clint, Bobby, Lea, and I, for us, this is about opening people's eyes about mental health. It's about spreading the word and giving them that space so that people will be able to talk about them. So for Lea and I, this is a passion project. It's something that we love to do because it's a phenomenon that we both advocate for. Pero teka, may disclaimer ako, sinabi kong hindi naman siya kakanta. She's also a fabulous actress,
yes,
syempre,
yes,
no?
Yes, yes.
But it's not about that, eh. It's not about showing off who's better. It's about telling a very unique story. Kasi yung Miss Reyes niya, iba rin sa Miss Reyes ko.
Ah,
ibang-iba.
Really?
Yes, so you can't even compare because they're two different people.
Really?
Yeah, we're not really alternates in the strictest sense of the word.
Yes, yes.
They're two different plays.
But my gosh, I think it's worth it, honestly, to watch you both.
Yeah, it
because
is.
Because it also
definitely
improves the discipline of the viewer.
Yeah.
Right? To expose,
yes,
the Filipino viewer. Are you going to have students coming?
Yes,
are
we
there?
Have,
okay.
We have students coming, and we also have caregivers coming and
fabulous
people who work in the industry.
Fabulous, yes, fabulous. Dolly De Leon,
thank
my
you,
gosh.
Thank you, Karen.
You are magnificent. Huwag mo ko kalilimutan.
Hindi talaga. Ikaw magfa-fund ng production company ko.
Remember, mami, hindi na natin maabot si Dolly De Leon.
Ay, grabe naman.